this is Beatrice. I'm a volunteer calling regarding the upcoming elections on July 22nd.
Hi, Mr. Allen.
And I'm just checking to see if you plan on voting in those elections.
I'm a volunteer calling to remind you about the upcoming
Great to
US
hear.
Senate.
If you don't mind me asking, have you decided yet who you're supporting for US Senate?
Will you be voting in that runoff? That's great, sir. And if you don't mind my asking,
okay, well, I'm actually calling today on behalf of David Perdue's Senate campaign. Do you have any questions or issues that I can answer for you today?
Okay. Well, I'm actually calling on behalf of the
Okay, well, I hope that Mr. Perdue can earn your vote on July 22nd. You know, he's an outsider. He's never ran for political office. So, you know, he's someone new. And he's counting on your vote.
Thank you for support. And would you like a yard sign?
Thank you so much. Have a great day.
Okay. Well, thank you so much for your support, sir. And you take care now. Thank you for your time. Bye.
If you would, both of you, walk up and just point your signature.
There's a lot of it.
I feel so good. It's not worth it.
Did you just sign it?
Did you just sign it?
I think you
all signed it.
Joey, why don't you make a phone call?
Hello, guys.
Strawberry syrup.
trip around the. I looked at all the stops.
I know, where are the stops? But
you know,
we reached pretty close to
schedule. Yeah, right. Vanilla, chocolate, strawberry, and then you have.
I finally made it over here for the ice cream.
Our choice. Well, we broke it down to three.
I know. Chocolate
and strawberry.
Just come back.
Come back.
People are being shy. Those people are telling
us. They chocolate.
There you go, your spoon. You can create your own spoon and have yourself.
If you need more cream, we'll put that on for you.
We have some homemade cream. Would you like some whipped cream?
Looking for trash? That's a good question. I'll tell you what. Let's make one. Yeah, we should. Let me see if I can find one.
There we go.
Let me just take that for her. I see one over there. Let me see if I can wheel one over there.
Right here. It is better fat.
Yeah. Doing all right, son?
Yes. You were talking about this.
I know fighting traffic at 7 o'clock in Atlanta isn't an easy thing, but you know, David really wanted to get some folks, some supporters in the metro area, some of the key leaders from around the state to be able to make it up and say thanks and just chat with y'all a little bit before we start our second statewide bus tour that's gonna be a lot of fun. So we appreciate y'all coming out. David appreciates it. We just wanted to turn it over to Neal Purcell, our finance chair, to kind of kick things off.
All right, thank you very much. And let me add my thank you also for taking the time to come out. You know, if this RV tour is as successful as the first one, we'll have really good news in about 2 weeks. But in the meantime, they're going to make, I think, 50 stops in places all over the state. They're going to eat a lot of barbecue, a lot of chicken, a lot of grits. But you know, the most important thing they're going to do is they're going to meet a lot of voters that are going to make David Perdue the next U.S. Senator from the state of Georgia. I said when I first started working on this about a year ago, I've known him for 30 years. Now it's 31. The first 30 years were fun. The 31st has been a lot of work, but it's paying off. David was a neighbor of mine. I've worked with him. I've played golf. I know David Perdue. And what I know is I like David Perdue. I trust him. I also have gotten to know through his advertising, both on TV and radio and through his flyers, I know Jack Kingston. I don't like Jack Kingston, and I don't trust Jack Kingston. Anyone that would resort to the kind of what I call egregious untruths just to stay in Washington, a place he's called home for 22 years, and by the way, has done nothing while he's been there for 22 years. Some of the stuff that he's put out about David makes my blood boil, and I'm sure it does the same for you. So, the way to correct that is on July the 22nd, get our friends, our family, anyone that you know, to go to the poll and cast a vote for David. All of the advertisements that Jack has put out, whether it's print, whether it's media, electronic, whatever, all of that, plus all of the establishment endorsements he's been able to corral, will mean absolutely nothing, because the next senator from the U.S., from the state of Georgia, the next U.S. senator, is going to be my friend of 31 years, and Bonnie Perdue's husband, David Perdue. So, David.
Hey, I really appreciate you coming out here, but I got to tell you the truth. The reason we did this is I want to get some ice cream tonight. So, hey, first of all, I want to thank you for what you did during the primary. I mean, we came out of nowhere and actually got more votes than anybody else, and that's why we're standing here in this runoff. That was our first objective. Our second objective is to beat Jack Kingston on the 22nd. But don't forget, our ultimate objective is to beat that Democrat this fall and put a Republican back in the Senate, because we will not give Harry Reid one more vote in this United States Senate, right? So how do we do that? Well, we've done all we can do up to now. We've done it as hard as we could. And we've out-hustled the other guy. We really have. Our grassroots has out-hustled them. Our fundraising has out-hustled them. We think we've got a better message. And by George, I know that I can make a bigger difference in the Senate than he can. If I didn't believe that, I wouldn't be here. I got in here because we got a crisis, a mess in Washington. We all know it. It was created by career politicians, and we just can't trust them to fix it. If you want to tell your people what the central message of this race is, Jack Kingston's been in office for 22 years. If he were going to make a difference, wouldn't he have done it already? That's it. You don't have to go any further than that. Herman Cain's going to be on radio all week next week, hammering about how all these untruths are untrue, backed up by all these outside pundits that have verified that they're not true. Don't worry about that. That we're going to take care of that. Tell the people what I just said. Jack's been there 22 years. Whatever you think about the world, if he were going to make a difference, wouldn't he have done it already? It's time for a fresh perspective. That's why we're in here. I look at faces out here, and all of you have done yeoman. Many of you have never been in politics before, never done anything in politics. And I got to tell you, that's so sobering to me. I haven't either. And I feel your pain on some nights. But it's how our democracy is supposed to work. And it is working right now. We're going to win on the 22nd. We're leading this race right now tonight. I can look you in the eye and tell you that. And it's even more encouraging than that because we're making great inroads in certain parts of the state. And right now, we've got the momentum. We're going to keep it up on this truck. Do not leave without signing this truck. This is my endorsement right here from people like you. So we're going to be out for 10 days, over 50 towns, meeting people just like you all over the state. And we're going to be talking about what is in their head, what's in their mind. We're going to be telling them exactly what I just told you. Jack's been there 22 years. If you're going to make a difference, wouldn't he have done it already? We're going to talk about why I'm in this race and what I hope to accomplish. And it's going to be a great time. I'll lose about 15 pounds. We'll eat about 25 Chick-fil-A's every 3 days. But we will see a lot of this state from Hayhira to Hiawassee. I love saying that. But it's true. We will. And I want you to pray about it. I want you to tell your friends. And the number one thing right now is we have got, somebody said it at lunch today, and I think it's so true. We're in the lead right now, but it's close. We just got to push to the finish line. We push the finish line the way we did in the primary. We win this thing. So God bless y'all. Thank you so much. I'm going to turn it over to Alec Poitevint, who is one of our campaign co-chairs along with Neal. And these guys, I wouldn't be here without both of them, I will tell you. And I wouldn't be here without you. And I just want to say you from the bottom of my heart, you've got other things you could be doing. I know that. And I really, really appreciate it. Bonnie and I both do. What you've done, what you're doing, and what we're going to do to win this thing. Thank y'all. Alec.
Let me start off by first of all saying thank you. It's the most important thing we can say about what you've already done and what you are doing, because as you come down this stretch, you know, on the 14th day from the day is when we have this election. And people say, well, you know, I've been doing everything I can, what can I do? Well, my bride Doreen's riding up today, and she has a little nap, and then she wakes up, she turns on a cell phone, and she starts calling every single person she knows and telling them where we're going and what we're doing, and that they ought to go vote now, and they ought to make sure their friends get voted, and that she hopes that's the case. If you need any questions about Dave Perdue, give her a call back. And so for us, you live in Bainbridge, Georgia, it's 3 hours and 50 minutes to this bus, okay? So for about 3 hours of that time, we've been making those phone calls. Well, you know, that nap she took, I can't forgive her for that. That was wasted time. But y'all do have to do some sleeping. But other than sleeping when you need to, what you need to do is to make sure that you work every single contact that you got, because we have the right candidate with the right message at the right time, and we can get this job done. We have the momentum. I actually enjoy riding on these buses. I'm a professional bus rider, and Doreen's been trained to do that. We're looking forward. We are going to stop at Chick-fil-A, and we're also going to have peanuts, and we're going to move around the state, and we look forward to the challenge of it. We look forward to meeting all these people and a chance for the people of Georgia to see this person who can make a difference in Washington, D.C. It's just not somebody else. It's all of us. He's the one running. He's our team. Let's go make a difference. Thank you very much. God bless you.
Hey, how are y'all? Hey, this is
sign?
This is what it's here.
Oh, good.
This is why we're going to
do it. Yeah, it's good to see you.
We're working on it.
What is it?
Yeah. I know, it's good here too, but I'm fine.
Okay. Well, that's Ronnie and Cobb, too.
I don't think we can trust Senator Fitz. I've spent 40 years in business, and right now with only about 10 people in the Senate with any business experience, we need that perspective up there. Get this economy going and solve this debt crisis.
What do you think Republicans' chances of taking the Senate?
I like them right now. I mean, the Democrats have set the table for us. Obamacare alone should be the topic of the day, and now you got this immigration crisis going on. I really believe that the table is set for Republicans to retake the U.S. Senate.
What do you think Georgia's number one issue?
Oh, it's no question. Jobs, economy, and the debt. I mean, you go around the state talking, that's what they'll talk about. They're very upset with the results coming out of Washington. That's why I did so well in the primary. I really believe they're looking for a fresh approach to get something done for us.
that? What kind of response have you got across the state?
Well, you know, the results in the primary speak for themselves, but more importantly than that, the message is resonating around the state. We've been all over the state over the last year and a half. Everywhere we go, people are very concerned about what's going on in Washington, and they're really looking for a fresh approach. What they're concerned about is their relatives are out of work. Their kids can't find jobs. This debt crisis is real to them, and right now, they just get frustrated that Washington's not doing anything to get this economy going.
What kind of response have you gotten from people about Obamacare? I mean, what's the feeling?
Well, they're really very, very angry about it. I'm one of them. I mean, they canceled my own insurance. My wife and I lost our insurance. Our rates doubled. We have to have all these coverages now, including maternity. My wife's about my age, and so we're not going to have any babies. So they're very outraged that the federal government would step in and take over this entire program like this, and they want it repealed. They want it replaced in this state.
Thanks.
That's great. Thanks.
Thanks so much, man.
Thank you.
Hold on, I'm going to take your picture of you signing the bus to send to my dad and I'll make him happy.
Hey, how are you? Oh my goodness, y'all got some good ones here.
That's right.
Both these years?
Okay, this is Mr. Purdue, and I know that he would love a high five.
I would love a high five.
There you go.
That's
good.
Thank you. Thank you so much.
Yeah. That's
here, we can get one of them. Hey, Austin, we can get mom and dad in here too. Austin,
here,
I'll take a picture. Let's get mom in. You can't take a picture of grandkids without grandma in
here.
One, two, three. Get a couple more. There you go. You saw
a plan to choose from. Thank you very much.
Did you sign the bus? Did you sign the bus?
He did.
Gotta go. Nice.
We're gonna work hard. Are you getting a picture of the two of them?
I'm so proud to do it.
I want to make sure everybody got an ice cream. Well, thank you. We're working hard to get there. No, I feel good about it.
Oh, it's so nice to finally meet you.
Y'all are machines. Good luck to you.
Thank you. Where did you sign? Huh? Where? Did you not put eight in Atlanta?
Yep.
Oh.
God's coming.
Is there a cell phone up there? I was like, I'm the ladder. This is my phone. I should have put that. Can I get that to you?
My screen?
Oh, you gave us bullet points.
Yeah.
Well, they run out now.
Oh, sorry. We are bulleted.
Morgan.
I guess.
But it's not. Yeah, it'll be a time to start off with.
Hi.
I signed the bus and I said, good luck, David, and P.S. Bonnie, you're a trooper. Because you are.
Thank you.
All right, thank you. Y'all can back up.
Thank you.